Time now to catch up with ITV Fixers, our campaign to help young people do something they feel strongly about to benefit others.
Well, since we launched this a month ago, more than 300 young people have started ITV Fixer projects, from tackling bullying and intolerance to helping wildlife conservation.
Well, tonight, the story of a brave young woman who suffered abuse as a child. Now she wants to help others.
I am a 17-year-old girl. I was abused by my father sexually up until the age of 14. I don't even remember when it started. It ended when I told my mum on Christmas of 2005, and she told my brothers and they went to the police about it. 15 months later, there was a trial and we won, and he's been put away for 3 years. For my ITV Fixers project, I would like to make a website in the hopes that I will be able to contact other survivors and form possibly a sort of union group. I think we'd be much better equipped to support victims who are just coming out about their abuse because we've been through it ourselves. You feel like you're alienated on an island, separated from the rest of society, who just don't understand, or even though they try to, they might understand from a clinical point of view, but emotionally they've got no idea. I felt like a clinical lab rat by these other organisations who tried to support me in most cases, because people can't relate to the kind of things I've been through unless they've been through it themselves. On the website, I'm hoping to put on articles that I've written myself about sexual abuse based on my own experiences. I'll have a rough autobiography on there. I'm hoping to have the input of a professional psychologist just for a sort of professional opinion on top of my own.
What do you think about my idea to get a group together to support each other and raise awareness of child abuse?
I think it's incredibly valuable. Yeah. And to actually feel you can do something, yeah, and you can take some action and you can change something.
She was worried that if I put anything too interactive on my website, I could attract the wrong people. So will you help me with my website?
Yes, I'll help you in any way I can. Yeah.
Yeah. This morning I met up with a group of web designers.
We're the people that designed this website for ITV Fixers. So what I suggest you do is just get a nice sheet of white paper, and then on it you will literally just start plotting your site. What sort of things do you think you'd like to say?
Articles, where to get help, or get help now, !
Okay.
I like the phoenix idea because phoenix represents rebirth and new hope and new beginnings, and I think that's quite appropriate for what I'm trying to do.
He's quite a nice one.
Bit too masculine.
Too masculine. See, you're thinking along the right lines now.
I feel that producing a website about my experiences with a view to helping other people who have similar experiences is another stage of recovery. I'm feeling quite enthusiastic about the whole thing. It feels great to be able to use my own experiences to help other people, and obviously I'm getting a lot of praise for that as well, which is always good. If I can just help one person, or even just point one person in the right direction, then I'm happy, really.
Amazing story.
Yeah, very brave to speak.
Yeah, indeed.
Well, if you'd like to become an ITV Fixer, find out more by calling 01793 68 0030 or visit the website at itvlocal.com/ITVFixers. Calls cost a maximum of 8p a minute from BT landlines. Costs from other networks may be higher, and mobiles will be considerably more.
And we'll be catching up with other ITV Fixers projects in regular updates to come.